Okay, we're back. So here's the drill. So Steve Smith, everybody knows Journey, right? And they think, oh, Journey, kind of this poppy band from the 70s and 80s. But really, if you listen to Steve Smith, he's playing all kinds of cool stuff in Journey. I think most people, to the average just listener who's listened, they just hear him playing, Don't Stop Believing, which, by the way, is really kind of an intricate rhythm. A lot of weird stuff going on with the cymbals and stuff. But they just kind of hear, Open Arms or whatever, these ballads. One of my students recently was working on, or a couple of them actually, working on Separate Ways, and there's those cool, really fast triplet fills at the end of Separate Ways. So that's pretty tough because of the speed, really more than anything. But this is actually super easy. This one's actually th this is there's three fills in this song, and the rhythm is really a complex one. The rhythm goes something like this. So I think most of you can handle that one. That was a joke, by the way, for those of you who don't know me, for the thousands around the world, we're just tuning in for the very first time. So this song called After the Fall, probably never heard it before, but I used to wear out Journey back in the day because to me, Steve Smith was really my Neil Peart. Where most guys were into Rush and listening, and I love Rush, don't get me wrong, but for me, probably as a high school kid growing up, I was more of a Journey guy. For those of you who know me back in those days, and some of you do, I mean, I was a Zeppelin guy also, but later on, I came to appreciate Steve Perry, or well, I did like Steve Perry too. Sorry, slip of the tongue there. Steve Perry, my favorite vocalist, right there with Steve Walsh from Kansas. This is getting into a vocal thing, which, by the way, I'm happy to sing songs for you, but that's for a different video. After the Fall, Steve Smith, there's three fills in it. You should listen to the song. The first two couldn't be easier, super simple. The third one, actually pretty complex. We're not talking about that one because this video is simple, but not always easy. Or is it easy, but not always simple? I don't know. I'll have to listen to the first time I mention it at the beginning of the video. But it's the same principle. So, but this one is pretty easy. One bar fill, and again, Steve Smith. All the ability in the world, can play anything he wants, but he takes it super easy here. Plays a one bar fill, very few notes. He does do one cool little thing at the end, which I like, but you don't even have to do it. And it's really just eighth notes, right? So here's the fill. The unbelievably talented, all the technique in the world, Steve Smith, and he does this fill. One, two, three, four. There you go. One more time. One, two, three. Four. Okay, so that's the fill. Okay, it comes at about the 2 minute mark in After the Fall. And the one cool thing that I didn't do, because I'm going to talk about it now, is he actually, so he plays eighth notes for the first two beats, one and two, or for the first three, right? One and two. Then beat two is a dotted eighth, 16th note, and I'll have the page up while I'm talking about it online. So beat two is a dotted eighth and then a 16th note, and that first hi-hat accent comes in on the One. Okay, one and two E and a three E and that finishes the three beats. One and two and one and two E and a three E and then he goes four and but then he plays the of four on an open hi-hat, which I appreciate. I think that's pretty cool. So one and two E and a three E and And those are the cool things that you'll see like a Steve Smith do, or you'll listen to him and you'll think, oh, this is just a basic song. And it is. But because of all his jazz background and all of his abilities, played with, Jean-Luc Ponty back in the day, Enigmatic Oceans, by the way, who doesn't want to listen to that record? I don't know anybody who doesn't want to listen to it. Everybody should listen to it. Let me say it one more time. Jean-Luc Ponty, or do you say Jean-Luc Ponty? I'm not really French, but I do enjoy the fries. Okay. Enigmatic Ocean's got a picture of Jean-Luc Ponty on the cover. It looks like he just rolled out of bed. Steve Smith, I believe it's the last the song on there. It's called something about taking a turtle to the ocean. I don't make up the titles. They do. I don't know. It was the 70s. Who knows what they were doing? So fast forward, he gets into Journey. They say, hey, none of that fusion stuff. We got to sell like millions of records and make millions of dollars. And he says, that sounds good to me because I've been living in a van down by the river somewhere playing with Ponty, making like $400 a week. I'll make like $4 million a year to play this. Sounds like a good deal to me. So anyway, that's what he does. And that's what he makes, probably. So there's the fill. After the fall, one beat, we're going to put it on. He's going to play it. Then I'm going to play it. And then you're going to play it because it's that easy. The only difference is you're not going to get $4 million for playing it. You might, but not from Journey. Perry just the best soprano, male soprano. I mean, it's so clean. By the way, Steve Perry, a big Sam Cooke fan, and I like the I feel as though like I'm a little bit of a musical historian for you youngsters out there. Sam Cooke, if you listen to a Sam Cooke back from the Motown days, Steve Perry basically is Sam Cooke. Basically, if you want to talk about someone who sort of mimicked their idol, Steve Perry is singing like Sam Cooke. If you listen to Sam Cooke. A record. So anyway, might do a little homework and listen to some Sam Cooke. You probably won't hear the drumming of Steve Smith on Sam Cooke, but Steve Perry, as much as his people talk about emulating your idols, there's a good example because he basically was being Sam Cooke of the 80s in a rock band. I'm sure he had other people too, but anyway, one of my favorite voices. Okay, there's the fill. One and two and a three and a four. Now, the sticking, whatever. I don't know what you want to do. You can change it up. You know me with stickings. You can make it your own. I kind of play it 1 and 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1. 4 and a 1. I suppose you can go 4 and a. But then you're going to come right off with the high, with the after the and crash with your left hand. Why? Play two rights. It's a slow tempo. 4 and strike that hi-hat with your left hand. 4 and a. And then come on here with the crash on one. Four and a one. Four and a one. Four and a one. Or for you traditional grip players, which I don't think there are any except for me. Four and a one. Four and a one. One, two, three. But that's a great little... That little open hi-hat on it's just cool. It just is. So those are the little things you could do to make a simple fill sound kind of hipper than it really should. But the song's really basic, so let's back that up. It's probably one of, even for Journey, even one of the most basic Journey tunes. So let's back that up a little. Sing this next time, and then I'll have half the viewership. Although that would only be about three people then. If I split six by half, it's three and three. Okay. Okay. So there you go. After the fall, I'll put it up on the board. That's it. 1 and 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 and a 1. Okay. There's three fills. The third one is a little more complex. He does something similar to this, and then he comes back with this buzz roll, which is really cool. Totally unlike, again, a pop or rock song, but he's not just a pop or rock drummer. That's another thing to pay attention to, is that he's like, you know, a world-renowned drummer, plays all styles of music. So you get these nuances from him that you don't get when you're listening to Tommy Lee play with Motley Crue. Great rock drummer, but you're not going to get any nuance. You're going to get a guy slamming, spinning upside down in a cage, and barely wearing any clothes. And if you're into that, go for it. But if you want like cool drumming, you got to listen to the cool players, right? And so Steve Smith back in the day, and then Vital Information, of course. Who doesn't know Vital Information? Everybody I'm talking to. Okay, maybe not everybody, but some people know him. And you all should. So, by the way, Over and Out, Vital Information. I don't know what album that's on, but do yourself a favor. YouTube that. Steve Smith, Frank Gambale, Tom Coster. Forgot who's on bass. Baron Brown. Over and Out. That's a good one. That's one of my favorite Steve Smith performances. However, that one is a lot harder to play than this one. So, there you go. Three songs. Easy. Simple doesn't necessarily mean easy. There you go. Josie. Right? Chucky's in Love. One and then After the Fall, Journey, or that's it. Practice, practice, practice. I don't know what I got next time. I have an idea though. I do have an idea for next time. I should be doing a Weckl thing because I'm going to see Weckl on Thursday. I'm filming this on a Sunday. It'll probably be up on a Sunday night or a Monday, and then I will have seen Weckl on a Thursday, which means that following video will probably be me selling all my gear because I just watched Weckl. No, it won't be me selling all my gear. It will be me inspired and probably telling you something I saw that I really enjoyed. And then a week later, after Weckl, I go to see Dream Theater, which I'm sure some of you know, and I've never seen them before, and Mike Portnoy is the guy who played on all the successful records, I guess. And Mike Mangini is playing with him now. And it's a lot of math and a lot of stuff that might make me need some Tylenols by the end of the night. However, I'm going to go check it out and see what I hear. And I might have some interesting things from that. Joe Ceretti, Anais, to share with you from the Dream Theater experience. So, get ready, because spring is here, and I have sprung like a chicken out of an egg. I have sprung, and I'm ready to give you exciting drum lessons for the entire 2019. I'm smiling because I'm picturing me springing out of an egg. And I'm picturing my kids standing outside the door. Well, actually, not my kids, because one of my kids is in Pennsylvania. But my daughter standing outside the door listening to me going, "What is he talking about, springing out of an egg?" And I gotta admit, I have no idea what I'm talking about. After the drums, the drum stuff, I got a pretty good idea. But afterwards, totally winging it. This is like improv. This is like the Second City of drum lessons. And you won't find it anywhere else. Okay, that's it. I was gonna say hasta la vista, baby. I don't know why, because like I said, it's the absolute improv. So hasta la vista, baby. And I will see you. Does that mean bye? I don't even know what that means. I'm not bilingual. Remember, I went to a music college. We didn't have to take Spanish class. We took Odd Time Signatures with Ralph Humphrey. And by the way, I got to show you this seat I just bought. I got to say, the most comfortable seat I've ever used in my life. I saw it online and I said, I got to get it. So it is the, let me swing this around for you. It is the DW Airlift 9000 Series Throne, and I gotta tell you what, it's like sitting on an air cushion. I gotta tell you, absolutely fantastic. DW doesn't pay me, although they should, because we do share the same initials, in case you hadn't noticed. But the DW Airlift, not quite as well known as some of the others, but let me just tell you something. I could fall asleep on this. Then again, I could fall asleep on a lot of things, but actually, no, this thing here. This is intense. Let me just say, this thing is worthy of your consideration if you're looking for a new drum throne. It is a little pricey, however, compared to other drum thrones, but if you're willing to put in the extra cashola, I don't think you'd be disappointed, because this thing here is something. So anyway, it is one of those hydraulic lift things. Let me see, where's the hydraulic lift? There it is there. So it's got the hydraulic lift things, but this seat is, yeah, Your butt will thank you, believe me, after a long night of practice. There you go. DW Airlift, 9000 series thrown. You won't be disappointed, although your bank might be a little upset because it is a little pricey for a drum thrown. However, what the heck? You know, your butt deserves it.